Good morning to all of you. Today's chief guest, Dr. Kader Ali, Mr. Kumar, Dr. Pal, the other dignitaries on the dais, and ladies and gentlemen. Today, the topic on which I'll be talking is very specific, that is the millet. Before I start my presentation, I would like to extend my thanks to Mr. Soumen Das, with whom I have a long association, and he is the one who is into this agricultural program, and they are doing several such activities related to agriculture, food, and its real life applications. And many a time we had several interactions that how to make an individual healthy. And you all know that health is wealth. Whatever you think today, on what big things you are thinking, until and unless you have a good health, you cannot reach very easily to your goal. And this is the importance of health. And when we are talking about the health, nowadays we are talking about the lifestyle diseases. And I think most of you are very much aware that India is going to be the capital of diabetes and many other associated diseases related to this diabetes and your different relation, let's say, like example, neuropathy and different diseases. But what I can tell that many a time we can control this disease with the proper application or proper selection of food. Now, in which way? So, I would like to tell you a small story first. So, it is not moving. Slide is, yes. Yes. So, if we go to our history, then we can find that, I think Dr. Wali is there, so I don't feel like telling all this story, but very shortly I would like to tell that if you see the cultivation of millet, then millet was cultivated in India, but with the British colonial agricultural practices, they were very much insisting on the cash crop production. And that may be the transformational time which, and they used to torture the farmers who used to grow this type of crops, and they were insisting that you grow this cash crop like indigo, cotton, tea, etc. They were the one who were not allowing this particular millet in the delicious elite food dishes. And if we see the chronological production or productivity rate was gradually getting decreased, and a time came when an anti-campaigning was also going on about this type of food grains which were there, and as they were very much fond of rice and wheat, so it was getting just practiced among the that Indians who were there. But if we see the normal growth pattern in India, you can see that in each and every state, starting from north to south, east to west, everywhere this millet practice were there. I'm just telling why it is so. I'm just telling that there are several types of millet, and I will also tell you the anti-campaigning which were going on regarding this millet and its food value and nutritious component in that. If we see today's date, and it may happen. So this, I can tell you that this became politicized. And what has happened, you know, people started growing that rice, that paddy or wheat as the major grain in India. As a result of what has happened, you know, we are very much practiced to go for any food material which are the derivatives of either rice or wheat. So nowadays, this particular nutritional properties and its impact has been understood, and that may be the reason 2023 Prime Minister, he has announced that this is the International Millet Year, and that was the understanding of the importance of this millet and its food value. I will be coming gradually. You see that in India, 27% millet is getting grown in Rajasthan. And you see the other states are also producing. And if we compare our stand with the international forum, you see that the US, starting from US to Brazil, altogether the other countries, they are their production and productivity rate, which is much, much lesser than what we are producing in India. As a result, what is happening? We have the opportunity for revenue generation. And what we are telling that we are exporting this millet in several other countries, and we are earning our this revenue, and these are the statistics of which are there, and we are getting this particular revenue out of this. Now, if this is the statistics, if this is the importance of this millet, let us have some idea that what are this millet and what type of, what are the different varieties of millet we can access, we can have in our daily food packet. So if we see, this millet is otherwise known as, it is a small seed grain which is rich in nutrition. It has different varieties. It starts with pearl millet, finger millet, sorghum, fox millet, and so on. So it is the particular variety of crop that can be grown under extreme condition. It can be grown in arid or semi-arid land. Water consumption is very less compared to other crops which we are practicing. So these are some of these millets, and if we see at a glance the nutritional profile of this millet, then we can find that it is rich in fiber, it is rich in protein content, it is rich in essential minerals, and it has a very low glycemic index. So my Mr. Kumar, what he was telling in his speech, that yes, if a person is suffering from diabetes, so what he should do or what she should do. So I can give you some of the campaigning which was going on against this millet. Millet has all good things, but along with that, it has got some component which is not considered to be a very good for health. And people were publicizing those things, and it has to make this mind of the common people that, oh, millet, no, it is not. It has got anti-nutritional properties which may damage the system. It has got phytate, a very little content of phytate, tannin, polyphenol, oxalate. So when we are understanding a particular system, we should know the pros and cons of that particular system. And when we are just going for this, we should know that in which way one can go for the processing of this millet so that one can have the total nutritional value that can have a positive impact on the system. And if we are going for a simple shocking of this, we are just taking care of this particular phytic acid which is there. Simple fermentation can take care of phytate, tannin and anti-nutritional factor. And when we are cooking, most of this particular deactivation is taking place, and that is making this particular this crop as nutritious. Now, on the whole, if we go for the classification of this millet, we can go for this categorization of millet as positive millet, neutral millet and negative millet. So, when we are talking about the positive millet, you see that everything is good. Only thing is that what and when and which percentage we have to go for its selection. It has a very low glycemic index, it has a high fiber content, it has a nutritional density very high, and it needs a minimal processing time. So that way, if we are coming to the negative millet, you can see that glycemic index is high. Obviously, a person who is going with this diabetes or this type of lifestyle diseases should go for the appropriate selection of the millet for its the food component. So when I'm just talking about the biochemistry and I'm just comparing this, this is the science of millet. So when I'm comparing this with the conventional millet, conventional grain, millet and grain, you please see the carbs contain protein, fat, fiber content of the millet and the regular component, food component, what we are eating in the form of food. It in under any circumstances, we cannot tell that it is less than any such less nutritious. And you see that other components are rather very high compared to the regular practices which we are having. So what is to be done? We have to change our habit. Now, if we are just going for this different categorization of millet, that see Barnard millet, Kodo millet, it is rich in calcium, phosphorus, and you see after 30, 35, most of the ladies who are there, including me, they are just told that they are calcium deficient, they are anemic, and this type of diseases are very common in the girl who are 30, 35 years. So what should be the selection of this millet in case we are opting for it? Kodo millet, it is rich in protein and antioxidant. Little millet, vitamin B antioxidant. Brown top millet, it is magnesium and antioxidant. So this way we can categorize, we can go for the selection of the millet and we can include it in the form of our food component. So the nutshell, if I tell you that why millet are good, I'm just telling, if a person is hypertensive, so it is a very common disease after COVID, the people who are having a very good heart, very good respiratory system, I'll be telling they are blessed and they need not have to worry so much. But many a cases, many a time, we are suffering from hypertensive such feelings and so. So this millet has this anti-hypertensive properties. It reduces the obesity, it reduces the diabetics or that type of problem, anti-cancerous properties, and it reduces the risk of coronary heart diseases, which are very, very common nowadays for any common people. So when we are just talking about RDA of that age group and its intake, we can find that based on the that biochemistry we are just going for. Yes, 1 minute. I'm just concluding. Yes, so we are going for this the different composition of millet based on its selection. Here I have given you that fortified rice, sambar, and its comparison with the millet based diet, and you see the biochemistry of that particular thing. Here I'm just showing the nutritional profiling of this particular millet or millet based food item, and I'm just comparing it with a person who is deficient with iron, zinc. Zinc is a very common deficiency where most of the people, when there is a heavy hair fall, so one of the component which is deficient in the system is zinc, and this zinc can be provided by this millet and millet based diet. So calcium, magnesium, you just see the component which are very much essential for our system. So here I'm just telling that in a nutshell, I can tell that millet, which is a miracle grain, which is good to the farmer, which is good to our planet, and which is good for any consumer who will be substituting this particular rice, wheat, and its appropriate compromise with the millet based food. So at IIT Kharagpur we are working on different aspects of this, and different processing, that negative part which are there, we are trying to get rid of. In my laboratory we are working different cookies, and we are going for the fortification with different terms, nutritious food, high food value items. So here different millet-based work is going on at IIT Kharagpur, and including this, we have 23 hall of residence. In the hall also, we are organizing millet event, and these are the different items which have been produced with the millet, and millet day was celebrated, and we are going ahead with this, and these are the different hall, and we are going for this type of selection of the millet and its application. With this, I would like to thank you all for your patiently hearing. Thank you very much.